terms of the creator, is there a creator?
That's the only reason. In terms of the creator,
yeah.
All creators, bring
people
gods,
out of darkness into light,
are human creatures.
Alcoholic prostitutes.
So when you look at it,
let me make
this is something right in the first sentence.
Somebody who does not believe in God, well, it has much more of a risk for not believing.
What if you're wrong? What if that person is wrong? What happens to them?
You're the one who's taken a parachute, but the one that doesn't.
I have many reasons to believe in God.
You've misunderstood.
I have many reasons.
What you need to do.
I'm not talking about risk.
You're
talking about the percentage of putting your eggs in a basket, of all your eggs in one basket, and you don't actually know.
First of all,
but then you preach as if you do know. That it is 100%.
First of all, this parachute, where are we in context? Are we in the sky? Are we in the sky? Are we in the sky when we release the parachute, first of all? Are we in the sky?
Thank you, my brother.
Like, is there
thank you very much. Yeah, yeah. I just wanted to kill, you know.
Is it just the parachute?
Good man. You're a good man. Like, I respect you. And I saw your debates before, anyway, but thanks for coming over, man. You know, I was totally out.
What I'm trying to say,
you can have non-religion. It's not a problem for us as a Muslim to have now religion.
Okay.
And God will judge you one day for all your actions, not by just religion. But if you know this is Islam, that the real religion, the true one, and you're not practicing it, that's a difference.
Right.
Do you understand? Right. But you, if you believe, no, the Islam is not the right one, and there's no God exists,
right,
because you don't know God, look, that bee belongs to God. Majority of Muslims, they go to hell according to what the Prophet Muhammad said. Do you know that? I will tell you that.
I don't want to tell
you. Can I tell you? Ask you a question.
Can I tell you?
That sounds interesting.
I know, it does.
That sounds interesting.
I'm not finished. I'm not even talking.
I want to ask you a question.
The Prophet Muhammad says, end of the world, Muslims, the Ummah, they will divide to 73 sets.
Yeah.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
72 go to hell and one go to heaven. Do you agree with that?
Wow.
No. Can I tell you my understanding?
Can I tell you my understanding?
I'm not finished.
He asked us a question. Who are you asking a question
for? I'm not asking a question. Is that
you're just making a statement.
Is a hadith?
You're just making a statement.
I do agree with it.
Is a hadith? Is a hadith is exists? All Muslims agree about it.
Mean, that question, can I respond?
Mean, what the percentage of 72 of 73?
Can I respond?
That's 99%.
Can I respond? Do you know what my understanding? Do you know what my understanding is?
Your understanding.
My understanding is. I don't know. I don't claim to know everything.
Is your understanding the understanding?
No, exactly. I just said I don't claim to know everything.
Okay.
So my understanding is that Muslims, although they are believers, a majority of them will taste hellfire.
Taste
it. 1 minute,
have
a
minute. They will taste. They will taste hellfire. However, they will not abide there. However, they will not abide there.
Right. You said Muslims will taste hellfire, but not abide there. Not stay there.
In the name of Jesus, have mercy on me.
There's a number.
Say again?
A percentage and a number.
He gives us a number.
Yeah, but he says 70.
I know I've lost
70. Two of 73.
Okay.
I'm
going to say it to you.
Nowhere where you can be found.
We've got 77.
I read that in the Bible.
We've got 70 groups with 3 members. That means
once
them.
I was lost, and now I'm found.
He's saying groups. He was referring to groups. A group is a...
So you're trying to make a point. Group and percentages.
So that group could have 2 people.
Yeah.
Did he specify which group was the right group?
He gave the qualities
for it, I guess. Yeah, but how do we know now?
How do we know the opposite? How do we know the opposite? The heart, the majority go to hell.
All 73 will believe that they're the right sect. Yeah?
No,
all 73, I'm guessing.
Yeah,
so then which one's the right one?
If you look, it could be the opposite.
Can I ask you a question?
And you're telling me
what we're doing is we're getting into the crux of
how do you know you're in the right group?
We haven't even agreed on the creator. We haven't even agreed.
So we could be in the same group.
Brother, why have we gone from that subject? We haven't even agreed on the creator side. The top. Let's agree
you on that side. Humanity. What I wanted to ask you is, what is your belief in terms of the creator? Is there a creator?
In terms of the creator, all creators, gods, are human creations.
Alcoholic prostitutes, right. Rich,
so
rulers,
human creations, there is not an ultimate creator according to what you can say.
There is no, to my knowledge, there is no ultimate creator.
Can we follow this?
There is just transformation.
Okay, can we follow this through? I believe, I have many different reasons to believe in the creator and the revelation is sent out. Okay, one moment.
Believe in aliens.
Fantastic. I'm telling you my side. For me to then obtain, you know, the end goal, the paradise, the, you know, heaven. Now, let's say the counterpart is you. Where would you end up? What's your understanding of human beings? Where would they end up?
I'm going to end up. So when you die,
on the ground. What if you're wrong? So what if I'm wrong? One minute. If I'm wrong, and there's no creator, there's no ultimate hell, there's no ultimate after death, all that's going to happen to me is I'm going to die and go to the same place if I'm wrong.
However, let's pose that question to you. What if you're wrong? What if there is a creator, he gave us this revelation, he told us the way it is, and you chose not to believe it?
Are you now trying to scare me?
No. I'm asking you a hypothetical. What if you're wrong?
So listen, let me break down what you said.
Yeah.
Basically, what you're saying is,
mate,
you better do something, mate, or it could go tits up for you. Because what you're saying is,
to understand the other side of
this. No, this is what I'm saying.
Yes.
And if that is it, if God needs to scare people into believing, then
that's a red herring.
It's not a red herring.
Because I ask you a question.
I'm,
what if you're wrong? I never said you're wrong.
I'm listening to
did
what
I say you're wrong?
And it's layered.
Sorry, brother.
What
did I say you're wrong? I said, what if you're wrong? I said, what if I'm wrong? All I'm going to do is end up.
Well, is there a consequence if he's wrong? Is there a consequence if you're wrong?
According to my knowledge, no. There's no consequence.
Is there a consequence to you if he's wrong?
If he's wrong?
Yeah. From your perspective.
Of course there is.
And what's that?
He chose not to believe in this ultimate being that created him.
Yeah.
That showed him the right path. The path that the creator wants him to follow.
So if he's wrong,
my
brother.
This creator has not one, first of all, been verified. Two, ever revealed itself to me. Or three, has ever shown itself to anyone.
I don't believe he's shown itself.
That's not my sign. That's the Christian.
So what
we have signs.
No. The signs we have, are from human beings saying that they're signs. So when I said to you before that religion cannot exist without human beings, this is what I'm saying.
Mm.
Without human beings saying, you know what that is? That's a sign, you know? You know what that is?
If
there were no human beings, religion would not exist. Have human beings saying things. Oh, this was from so-and-so. Oh, that's a sign from so-and-so. Oh, that's a sign from so-and-so.
I don't like the word religion. I don't subscribe to the word religion. Islam to me is a way of life.
Okay, a person told you.
So let's talk about way of life.
A person told you that there's hellfire. This entity that you claim is God has never, as that entity told you.
It would make me question it, and then it would make me want to find out.
Has that entity told you personally, I don't know your name, just say your name's Derek. I'm going to call you Derek.
Ibrahim.
If you said Ibrahim, listen, mate. You see this hell place, you want to go there, mate? Because
yeah.
Like this, has he ever said that to you?
Who, the creator?
The creator, yeah.
What, showing himself to me and saying that?
So then how do you know? So what do you have then?
He's
all you have is human beings.
He's the creator. His creation, he's given a revelation to. He's shown us.
I'm saying, has he shown you? Has he spoken to you?
By way of a book, yes. By way of a book.
Why not?
Now, here we go.
Directly, why not directly to you?
Yeah.
Why him? What's so special about him?
No, what's
very special?
I think it's going to be subjective, isn't it?
If he shows himself to me, it's going to be subjective.
Exactly.
Now, however,
everything is subjective.
However, we've got
when
a
it
book,
comes to religion.
We've got a book that everybody, a believer or a non-believer, can objectively look at and then make a conclusion to themselves. All I'm saying is,
all the believers,
it's the onus is on you to find out.
Okay.
What if you're wrong?
Okay, so. After I look at this book, I join one of those 73 sects, and I say, listen,
Why are we talking about sects? No, listen. I'm saying,
don't talk to me.
Talk to somebody else who prescribes to religion. Talk to somebody else who prescribes in the word.
Situation.
I don't prescribe in the word religion.
I said the way of life.
It's the same thing. A religion uses a way of life.
73 ways of life that everyone thinks, yeah, this is the way.
What's the difference?
Religion does mean a way of life.
I don't prescribe to the word religion.
No, sir, what's the difference between religion and way of life?
Maybe religion's identity. It's where you're from, basically.
Okay.
To me, Islam is a way of life. It's a path.
I feel like
has shown us the path.
Okay, this way of
life. I thought it was like to do something religiously, it's a way of life.
There will be 73 sects of this way of life.
No,
I'm asking you, didn't. Okay, so do you believe, as someone who follows this way of life, do you believe that there will be 73 sects of this way of life?
I don't know how much, but I believe there's one way, there's one path. There's one way of life. I said I don't know.
10 minutes ago, you agreed him saying that there were going to be 73 sects of Islam.
Okay, I didn't say that.
No, he
didn't give me a chance. He didn't give me a chance. Remember?
Don't lie.
He didn't give me a chance. I agree.
Don't lie.
I agree. He didn't give me a chance. But however, let me clarify my answer.
You don't agree with him?
I do not know about 73. One is right, one is wrong. All I understand is that there's one way of life according to Islam. Islam is a part, it's a one way of life. However, it could be 100 people.
Do you know that ISIS believes that? They believe that they're on that path.
Why are we going to bring ISIS?
No, because I'm trying to say it's subjective. I'm trying to show you that it's subjective. You're speaking as if it's objective.
It's revelation. You can test it out your
way. I believe that they're following one way.
That's up to them.
Exactly, and they're saying, well, that's up to you. They're saying your way, well, that's up to you. So it's subjective. Do you understand?
Can I give you more to you? I
walk one day at a time
with Muhammad Chai.
With Jesus.
When Allah sent the Quran, told him, there's a hypocrite Muslims around you. You don't know them, I know them. And the same Quran said the hypocrite is in the need of hell. So that means there is division.
But what's that got to do with what we were talking about creation?
It's got everything.
Can we agree on something first, and then we can talk about Islam and the different subjects?
I told you,
subjects.
All gods are creations of human beings.
What if you're wrong? What's the consequence? So, for me, what if I'm wrong? According to your understanding, what if I am wrong? What happens to me? I still end up in the same place.
You cannot qualify God without human beings. I'm showing you. That I'm not wrong. I'm showing you that I'm not wrong.
How can you say you're not wrong?
I'm showing you how.
Because
I showed you without human beings, there's no talk of God. Yes or no?
The word God, yes.
Logically speaking,
we made that word up, God. English word.
Creator, God, whatever you want to call it, Allah, Jesus,
let's talk about
the whatever.
Okay.
Let's
talk about the concept. Let's not name a word. The concept.
I'm talking to you.
Let's talk about a concept.
The only way I can describe it is saying creation. Right. And creator.
Is God a concept?
Yes.
He should have a lot of.
Of course, he's an ultimate being. He's a creator.
No. Do you know what a concept is? A concept is an idea. That's what a concept is.
No, I don't agree with that.
No.
He's not an idea.
Of course, he is an idea. There's nothing else. There's no way.
You're asking me. I'm saying
an idea comes from here. Right, the human mind, imagination, wherever. There's no human being you can speak to on the planet when you talk about God that when they speak, they're not talking about what's up here. Yes or no?
That's quite interesting. Can I ask?
Yes or no?
That's quite interesting.
They're not speaking about what's up here. So without this, there is no God.
Can I give you a very interesting story? Not a story, but a very interesting project. There are tribes in the Amazon rainforest where they've never had any access to society, so modern society. There are some tribes out there, correct? There was a study done years ago, maybe 30, 40 years ago, about one particular tribe in the Amazon rainforest where some of the things that they were saying, they actually believed, although they don't know this word God or creator, they believed in this one
entity,
deity that created them.
Right.
They actually found ways of
worshipping or, you know, paying praise to it. Exactly. That's what Islam believes, actually. There's this innate belief, this position for you to know you are rich. So you have to actually work hard in terms of, you know, how you are brought up,
the things that you are access to, whatever, to actually go against that thing.
This thing you're born with, that's what we believe. Okay. How do you contend with people like that rainforest? They've never seen TV, they've never seen white people, they've never seen revelation, they've never been read.
You're not understanding my point. If, regardless of where you go around the globe, people have deity. They've all come to the same conclusion.
I can't love you.
It wasn't me that did it, somebody else did it. They've all come to that conclusion.
So, the reason why I brought that up, you said it's an idea.
But it is an idea. Because when you say that,
if you man had an identical twin,
the story that they'll give about it.
But other than that,
the story.
No,
it will be some will be similar, some will be different. Because they're not going to talk about Muhammad.
Just as a right. I'm saying that actual concept of a creator.
No, you're not hearing me. All human beings have come to the same conclusion around the world. It wasn't me, it was something else. All human beings have come to that. They know, I know I didn't do it. And I know this whole universe stuff, it wasn't me, something else done it. Right? Was it me? Something else? We've all come to that conclusion. But the ideas, the concepts that we come up with to explain that are what we call God. Allah, Yahweh, Jesus, Vishnu, whoever you want to speak to, they have a different concept as to who or what that thing is. So that's why I said gods are just human concepts. The one thing we know is that we don't know.
You agree with that fit of that?
That's the one thing we know.
I agree with that.
The one thing we know is that we don't know
nothing.
We don't know. Okay, so you can't prove me wrong.
That's it.
No. I've got reasons to believe.
What I proved is that all human beings have concepts of God. That's what I proved.
Doesn't mean that there isn't a God.
Why? Because you don't know. Because you just said we can't prove it. If I say, listen,
and that's the name of Jesus.
There's a crazy man behind that. I've made an assertion. You're just chilling there, standing by yourself, and I said, mate, there's a crazy man behind that curtain. You have every right to hang on a minute. How do you know there's a crazy man behind that curtain? If I say to you, you can't prove there's not.
I did not.
You weren't even there.
It's transformed, though. Because he said, I believe, and then he said, how do you know? So there's two words here. Belief and know. So it transforms, and you need to stick on either belief or knowing. You can't merge the two to argue.
Chances are that maybe you shouldn't take that word.
Believe. If you just said there's a crazy man behind that curtain, how do you know that?